Hi everyone, welcome back. Weekends are very special and food makes it even more. Due to the COVID situation, we have been avoiding the outside food for quite some time, but that does not stop me from enjoying some of my favorites. Today was Saturday and I thought of trying out one of my all-time favorite chicken lollipop. So, keep watching. Early in the morning, I started with the preparation as I was planning this for the dinner. The lollipops need to be well marinated, if not overnight, at least for 8 hours to bring out the real flavors. There were chicken wings in the fridge which I had to clean, cut and turn into lollipops. Now this is the most tedious part of the whole recipe, but believe me, it is worth it. Preparing the marination, I needed the ginger garlic paste. So now, preparing the ginger garlic paste, I took some garlic and a small piece of ginger, added it to the blender and blended it to a fine paste, adding very little water. Remember, the proportion of the garlic should be little more than that of the ginger. If you have a ready-made one at home, then you can use that too. But I did not have. Getting things ready for the marination. Adding salt as per taste. Black pepper powder around 1 teaspoon. 2.5 teaspoons of ginger garlic paste. 1/2 teaspoon. And from my masala box, I added around 1 teaspoon of red chili powder. I am using the Kashmiri red chili powder, which gives a very good color and is little less spicy. Around 2 teaspoons of soya sauce. And then you need to mix well, as every lollipop should be well coated with the marinade evenly and thoroughly. After marinating, I'm going to cover and leave it on the counter for around 20 minutes and then keep it in the fridge till I use it at night. It was dinner time and I got back to preparing the lollipops. First, preparing the batter. I took around 1 cup of all-purpose flour, that is maida, 1 cup of corn flour. To it, I'm adding around 2 teaspoons of ginger garlic paste, 1 teaspoon of red chili powder. Here I'm using the Kashmiri red chili powder. Salt and then a quick mix. I wanted to give a little twist, so here adding some crushed ajwain, that is carom seeds. This is totally optional and it can be skipped, but believe me, it adds an extra flavor. If you have it at home, do add it and try it out. This batter has to be of correct thick consistency. Hence, it is very important to add water in less proportions and mix so that the batter should not turn runny. You need to be very careful here, otherwise it can mess out the whole recipe. Adding 2 drops of food color, red food color I used. This is totally optional and you can skip if you want to. Then, taking one lollipop, dipping in the batter and coating it well with the batter. So the oil is on the medium flame and I'm going to drop in the chicken lollipop pieces. So you will have to alter the flame between low, medium and high. That's how I'm going to fry all the chicken lollipop pieces. You can single fry and right away serve it. But if you see in the restaurants, they single fry and then they double fry the chicken lollipop, which makes it very crispy. So I'm going to follow that. And here you can see that I'm double frying the chicken lollipop right now. This makes it very crispy, just as the restaurant. Chicken lollipops were ready and I served it with tomato ketchup as I did not have Schezwan sauce. Hope you like this video of mine. Very soon I'll share another interesting video with you. Till then, bye-bye. Take very good care of yourself.